Besides filtering, we have another way to do conditional reporting, and that's known as action states. To demonstrate this and to set this up, let's take a look at a slightly different event frame. Here we have a single parent event frame that's 30 minutes long called ChemX123. We have two custom attributes, pressure and pressure threshold. During this time period, we have pressure swings that happen, and when it goes above a specific threshold, maybe about 10.5, we'll say, we want a way to be able to report on these critical time periods. And what I mean by critical is we want to know the start and end times that each of these instances happens, the pressure, plot of the pressure during each of these times, and the maximum pressure that it reaches during each of these times. And this again will be done using action states. To give you an idea of what we want the final table to look like in the report, here we have our plot, and we have different time periods marked as OK versus high pressure. And we'd like a table that says which state we're in, the start and end time of each state, the duration, the maximum value reached during that state if it was a high pressure time period, and what the trend looked like during that time where we were under high pressure, where it was over 10.5. Let's go set that up in RtReports. And let's start by opening up the editor. I have started an existing report to do this, so let me open that up. And I'll select an event frame. And you can see I've brought in a few items, the product, the recipe, a table with the start, end time, and duration of the parent level of end frame, which is the only level in this one, and the pressure trend, which we were looking at earlier. And now I'd like to create the section that's going to divide this up and then put it into a table. So to do that, first we start in the data template. And based on what we've done before, you might think I would want to go in here into my pressure trend because we already have an action parameter here set up for the pressure. However, this one uses action results, and we need to use action states. And we shouldn't mix action results and action states into the same journal action. So what I'm going to do is create a new journal action. And this is going to be my pressure action states. And I'm going to go ahead and add my pressure here. This is an event frame attribute. And in my production database, I'm going to have to go find that. This is a procedure level event frame, and it's a derived one. And there's my pressure. In addition, I do want to bring in the pressure threshold, which is also part of that event frame. It is a constant, but it is part of my event frame. And then there's two messages I'm going to want to have indicate whether my pressure is okay or if it's over pressure or high pressure. Those are going to be constants, and I'm going to actually type them in here. It's a literal. And this one says okay. And this one I'm going to call high pressure. The actual words are high pressure. Okay. Let's go to the action states tab. And the action states are going to evaluate, and when it becomes a certain value, it changes to another action state. So first off, let's add our first action state. This is when it's okay. So when a new event comes in, it needs to evaluate the transition equation. And what that transition equation will be for us is if the pressure that it's currently evaluating is greater than the pressure threshold, that also needs to be in single quotes, then, and then this is which of the action states should you move to when that condition is true. And in this case, when the pressure is greater than the threshold, then we should switch to the second one. Else we stay in this one, which is index one. Okay. Then we have a second action state, and this is the high pressure condition. And actually the transition is exactly the same. If the pressure is greater than the threshold, we stay inside of this one. Else we would move back. So you can see how there's a huge amount of customizing that you can do as you write transition equations at each index, and then you can have them move between them. A couple things we need to discuss before we continue to move on. First is, how is this going to trigger? And that's based off of something called the interval. When you set the interval to -1, the equation is executed at the specific times that there's data in the archive. If you specify this as a positive integer number, the equations are executed at evenly spaced intervals between the start and end time by this time interval, which is in seconds. You can also specify a tag name, and it would be evaluated at the times that that tag has values. We're going to evaluate only at the times where there's data in the archive for our pressure tag. And in this case, then we're going to set our interval to -1. The interval is under action options, and I'm going to set that here, -1. Back under action states, we need to decide what information is gathered when we're in either of these two conditions. When we're in OK, all we want to do is gather the message OK. So I'm going to hit plus. I'm going to say simple. It's a literal, and it's actually just the word OK. And the result definition here is our message. When we're in state number 2, we want to gather something slightly different. We want to gather the same thing with the message. So I'm going to call this the same thing, message. This is also a literal. But I gathered the high pressure message instead this time. And we want to gather a few other things. We want the trend during the time period that we're in index 2. So I'm going to pick the trend. My data source here is the pressure. And I also want the maximum. So in that case, it's a summary value. I'm just going to call that maximum. And the data source here is the pressure. And I'm going to select maximum. And I'll go ahead and click OK. Let me say view refresh, and we'll take a look at what the journal looks like. You should make sure the journal looks OK before we actually try and bring anything into the report. If I go to journal events, this first event is the pressure trend. That's actually the one that I showed you at the very beginning. And the second one here is the pressure action states. So that's the one we just created. Up until now, we've only worked in terminal states. And those will actually be divided up by OK versus high pressure. So if you only wanted to report on a certain state, all of the high pressure states, and you wanted those in a table, you would probably use terminal state in this case. If you want them in order, even if they go back and forth between OK and high pressure, in time order. So for instance, this first one is OK. This second one here is high pressure, and they go back and forth. We would instead use sequence entries, which is actually what we want in our case. And we're going to iterate across these 7 entries that go from OK, high pressure, OK, high pressure, OK, high pressure, and OK. So let's start by just getting that into the table. And just to remind you, the table that we want looks like this. It's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 columns wide and 2 rows down. The 2 rows, the top row is going to be the header bar, while the next row is all iterated on. So let's go into the format template. And I'm going to add a new table. Insert table with 2 rows and 6 columns. In our 6 columns, I'm going to add different items here. The first one is the state, whether it's OK or high pressure. The next one is start time. Next is end time. Next is duration. This is the maximum pressure. And then finally, we have the pressure trend. The next set of columns for the row 2. So we need to iterate across this table row. And that's our journal entry here in sequence entries. So I'll go to expressions under my iterator. I'm going to bring in my journal entry. Our first table data here will be called, or will be the message, OK or high pressure. And that's the label, the value, OK. Notice that it says label equals message. And this is going to work because I called it the same thing, message. The label is message. Whether we're either in the OK or we're in the high pressure state. And just to remind you of that, let me go back to the data template. So when I click on 1, there's a result definition called message. When I go to index 2, there's another result definition called message. I could have technically have called those 2 different things, but because I called them the same thing, they're both called message. When I go in here and say label equals message, it doesn't matter which state I'm in, and it picks it up the correct item from the journal. Next will be the start time. So this is UTC time. And next is the end time. Also UTC time. And then finally, we have the duration. And I use the duration string, so I'm just going to say data. And before we move on, let me go ahead and save this, and I'll refresh it. Go to the report. So there's our pressure trend, and here's our table. Looks okay. We need to add that border in again. So we have what state we're in, the start and end time, the durations. And I'm going to add in next the maximum pressure and the pressure trend. So those are our last 2 columns. So let me go to the journal. Second journal event where the pressure action states are. We're going to again use sequence entries. Now, the maximum doesn't actually exist when there's OK, when we're in the OK state, this first one here. But it does when I'm in the second one, because now there's 3 results. This is the high pressure state. So the message came first, then the trend, and then here's the maximum. So I'm actually going to use this third result. say insert, and I'm going to say data. And I have to go into a trace set, find the correct column. And it looks like that first one where the property column is 22002 is the correct one. So if I go into my event, that's the value right there, the property descriptor 22002. I'm going to bring that over into my source and I'll click OK. Finally, we want to bring that trend in. So I say insert trend. And the trend was that second result. And it's actually value right here. So if I bring in the value, click OK, view, refresh, go to report. There's our start time, end time, duration, maximum pressure, pressure trend. I want to make that trend a little bit smaller. We can do that in here because it is inside of a table. Now we have a nice table that shows the seven different transitions, and you can clearly see the three times where we're at high pressure, and it gives us the maximum and the trend. We've now learned another way to do conditional reporting with the use of action states.